Today I have 6 tricks for you to use in Adobe Illustrator for your graphic design workflow. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. I've got many videos on this channel relating to tips and tricks for Adobe Illustrator, but I always keep things fresh for you guys, and so today I have 6 more tricks or tips for you to use in your graphic design workflow when using Adobe Illustrator. The first Illustrator trick for your graphic design workflow allows you to paste an object in the same position across multiple artboards. So if you take the artboard tool here and then hold down the Alt Option key, you can duplicate the artboard many times. So let's say I'm going to create a heading with the type tool. I can then copy it with Command or Control C. But if I then press Command or Control plus Alt plus Shift and plus V, it will be copied across many different artboards in the same position. This is a great tip for when you're designing multiple page documents, such as brochures or magazines. When you have many objects on your artboard, you can hide a specific selection of them with this Illustrator trick. Press Command or Control 3 when you have a selection of objects to hide them. And then you can press Command or Control Alt and then 3 to allow your objects to be shown again. This helps you organize and see your work when you have a very busy design in Illustrator. This next Illustrator trick for your graphic design workflow is very useful. When you have a selection of objects, you can group them together with Command or Control G, and most of us know that already. But then if you double click the selection, a grey bar will appear. You can now move an object independently around of the other ones with the selection tool, even though they are grouped together. You can then also press A on your keyboard to access the Direct Selection tool and edit the curves and the anchor points. And once you're done, click the grey bar once in Illustrator, and things will return to normal with the group selection. The fourth graphic design workflow tip is really interesting to play with, and it's great for digital illustrations. Press Command or Control R to show your rulers, and then make a rectangle around the entire artboard, using a stroke only and no fill. Then, pull a guide from the rulers on the left side and align it centrally down the document in Illustrator. So go ahead and open up the layers window here, or you can locate it in the drop-down menu. Create a new layer like so, and then access the pen tool with P on your keyboard. Draw a straight line down the middle of your new layer, and then increase the stroke weight if need be, and move away the guide. Select the bottom layer in the layer window, and then in the appearance window, click the effects tab. You then go to distort and transform, and transform. Type in reflect one copy, and check the X box here on the right. Now you can select the brush tool with B on your keyboard, and then when you draw on one side, you have a reflection on the other side. This is great for symmetrical illustrations, and you can also use shapes and pen tool paths, but everything is going to be reflected over the other side. I'm sure you can have some fun using this Illustrator trick, and you can use more than one reflection mirror if you want. For this next Illustrator trick to help your graphic design workflow, make sure you have a stroke and no fill in the color palette. Press M to select the rectangle tool like before, and generate a box around the entire document. Then go up to Object, Path, and split into Grid. You can now have control over how many rows and how many columns you want to use for your graphic design layout. You can then go ahead and select every single box and lock it down in place. This helps you create design work evenly spread out across the Illustrator document. The last trick in today's video helps you align objects to a specific object. So select everything and then simply click once more on an object. You will notice a thick blue line appearing around it. So now when you go into the align window and press an align function, everything will be orientated around that specific object that you selected. This has multiple functions across your graphic design workflow, such as aligning typography layouts and so forth. So what did you think of today's video on 6 tip tricks for Adobe Illustrator? Let me know in the comment section below, and also leave a comment letting me know what you want to see on this channel, if you have any opinions or suggestions. I'm always open to ideas from you guys. If you did like this video, give it a thumbs up, and also share it on social media if you did find it useful. Remember to subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.